to keep you by my side. Heart is starting to liquefy. Need you here to tell me that it'll be okay. Maybe one, love and two, and now it's three. 3 a.m. thinking, what if it's you and me? At the end, maybe we'll be okay.
Good morning, guys. Today it is Thursday, 6:30 in the morning. Today I'm going to be filming a morning routine and a night routine. So yeah, I'm going to see you guys later.
Tell me that'll be okay. Maybe one, love and two, and now it's three. 3 a.m. thinking, what if it's you and me? At the end, maybe we'll tell me that'll be okay. Maybe one, love and two, and now it's three. 3 a.m. thinking, what if it's you and me? At the end, maybe we'll be okay.
Okay, so quickly, I just wanted to explain what skincare products I use. So I use this Ultra Repair Cream. And then I use Vaseline Healing Jelly. I use those for my eyes. So, yeah.
My own conversations. Hoping you would come and save me. Know that you're coming back home in the morning. I hope that you're coming back home. Look at you. Eyes as soft as that ocean blue. Falling in, learn to swim like I never knew. I see it now, that everything will be okay. With no small doses, smell of roses. Can't get enough of you. Can't wait to love on you. I know that you're coming back home. Know that you're coming back home. Know that you're coming back home in the morning. I know that you're coming back home. Having my own conversations.
And then I use Vaseline on my lips so I don't get dry lips in the morning. And then next I go in with Cetaphil Moisturizing Lotion. I use this usually after the shower, but in the morning I use it for my neck because my neck is usually dry. So yeah. So I'm done getting ready. Well, not my makeup, of course, but I can show you my outfit. So quickly, I'm wearing this shirt. It's from Japan. My sister bought it for me. And then I'm wearing these jeans from American Eagle. And then I'm gonna wear jewelry that's also from Japan. So yeah, I'll see you guys when I'm doing makeup. Hey guys, welcome back. I'm trying to ignore my dog in the background because she's eating. But I just want to show you my makeup routine. Like, I'm not going to show you the full makeup routine because I showed it in my last video. And I kind of don't want this video to be too long. So, yeah. So, first thing. This is actually, I use highlighter Ilia for the second step of my makeup routine. It's in the shade Nova. I got it from Sephora. So, and I think it was like out of stock too. So, I got it. Last one they had. And then, but the first thing I really use is eyeliner, also from the brand Ilia. It's a great eyeliner. It's gel eyeliner, in fact. And then I use blush. I just picked it up from CVS because I'm not trying to spend even more money on Ilia. And I just use this like very little because, well, kind of shows up too much in the light. So I got that. It's in the shade, well, it's called Soft Powder Blush by Airlight. And then to blend in my highlighter and a little bit of my blush, I use a beauty blender. This is I blend in with the brush with like the bottom of this, and then I use the top to blend in my highlighter or whatever. And yeah, you guys get to see maybe a bit on my makeup routine. We'll see. Okay, y'all, so I'm back from doing my eyeliner. As y'all can see, it looks so bad in camera, but it kind of looks okay in person. Depends how you see it. Yeah, it really depends on how you see it. Okay, next thing we're gonna go in with the highlighter by Ilia in the shade Nova. And then I'm gonna blend it with this. So yeah, y'all can get ready, or not get ready. Y'all can see what I do with the highlighter. I kind of do too much, but it's fine. Okay. So I'm gonna tell y'all how school has been. School has been all right. It's not the most fun thing in the world, as y'all know. Obviously, if y'all go to school, but it's really been chill, I guess. I do have a big project coming up. well, I'm working on it now, but it's like due next month, so like around October, like the first week of October, it's due. And yeah, okay, as I was saying. I don't think I'm gonna do well. I got a 50 on my math quiz, so what a surprise. Yes, I am mad about that, but it's fine. We'll just keep moving forward. And y'all, I'm like dumb in math, so yeah, because like my brain thinks this is the right answer, but it's not. Like, do y'all know what I mean? Do y'all know what I'm getting from? Like, seriously. Y'all, so I just finished the cheeks for my highlighter. Next thing, I'm gonna go put highlighter here, and then my nose, and a little bit on my forehead. Really depends. So, for y'all. So, and I'm gonna try to post consistently once a week. It really depends if I'm available on one of the days. Like, it's not, because for 2 weeks in a row I've been doing it on Wednesday, but it's not always gonna be on Wednesday, just to inform y'all, just for reasons like school, duh. Okay, back to what I was saying. Now I just finished my chin. Now I'm gonna do my nose. Okay, damn, that was loud. Okay. So. Oh my gosh, I said, where did the word, bro? Like, anyways. Okay, I'm gonna talk about my school real quick. Why? Because, like, no offense. I know I look like a sixth grader and a seventh grader, but, like, be so for real, because they are literally the most annoying people in the world. Why do I say they're annoying? At my school? No, at my school, not, I'm not, like, attacking people from other schools. But, like, they're literally, they think they're, like, I don't know, they think they're older than us. That's what I'm trying to say. And, like, I'm surprised that, like, 6th graders and 7th graders are, like, getting shorter every year. It's really insane. And I know I was one of those short 6th graders, but, like, they're annoying. They're, like, cringy. But, like, I don't really care because I don't really talk to them. I say this because, like their comebacks are so trash. Like, they're, like, naming stuff from TikTok in 2020, and it's really funny. Like, y'all already know. It happens on my bus, too. Duh. And, like, I don't know. Like, it's really cringy. Like, you want to cringe so bad, but, like, you can't. Yeah, that's how I feel about them. It's definitely the 7th graders too. I'm not just attacking them. I'm just not attacking only the 6th graders. It's really funny. And then, as for my grade 8 graders, yeah, we still kind of act immature. I'm not gonna lie. I'm mature though. Kind of. I can promise I'm not lying. I definitely do good in school sometimes. Really depends on the day. If I get a good grade on some quiz or something, or like some assignment from science as an example. I'm just ranting. I don't know what I'm ranting on about, but whatever. And then next thing, I put a little highlight up here just to give it some glow. Okay, and then, oh yeah, this year we're gonna go to Six Flags for the field trip. As for 8th grade, it's only the 8th graders, and I don't know where the 6th and 7th graders are going, but but it's gonna be really fun. I don't think the sixth graders might go anywhere, because in sixth grade I didn't have a field trip. But I think it's only because it was COVID season. But I don't know, really. But in last year, in seventh grade, I did go to a tennis aquarium. It was kind of boring. People were rushing us. Like, even the chaperone was rushing us. I'm like, girl, I don't even got time to read any of these animals. Excuse me? Because, like, when you go to an aquarium, obviously you want to learn about the animals or whatever. Or just observe them, you know? And she gave us, like, 30 seconds, basically. And I'm like, how, girl, how? And I'm just, like, mad about that. Like, if you're gonna rush us, then let's not go to the aquarium, because I paid $70 to go there. And $70 was not worth it, let's be honest. But I think I went on another field trip. It was Stone Mountain. It was around May. And it was actually so fun. It was worth, and I would say it was worth the $70. People were crazy there, though. yeah. And then, yeah, it was really fun overall. And Stone Mountain, even though I've been there since I was, like, 4. That's all I could really say about Stone Mountain. There's nothing really much to say. I do have pictures, so I might show the pictures up on the screen. So if I do that, that's what Stone Mountain looks like if you've never been there. It's in Georgia, so yeah. It's really fun. Like, you can go hiking, you could go on the ski lift, I think that's what it's called. Or you can just go hiking or whatever you want. And we got to see a 3D movie, 4D, 3D or 4D. But overall, it's like really fun. It rained there, y'all. It rained. Like, I got soaked and I was mad. And like, it was not fun with the rain, but it was overall really great. We had to wait in this long line because we were going on this climb tower or something. But it was really fun, I'm not gonna lie. It was not as, like, I'm scared of heights, but it was not as scary as it seems, you know? So maybe just Stone Mountain just made it easier, I don't know. Because I did go on this other climbing tower, the Area Park, in this camp, and I was shaking. Like, I did not want to go past, like, the fourth level, but I did. Not the fourth level, the fourth obstacle. So I really only, and you do have a choice if you want to keep going. I did not want to pass level one, so I just gave up. That's how scared I am of heights. I did not do it this year, and like I said, it's at a church camp. But like, I didn't do the arrow part this year because last time I was scared, and I don't know how I was gonna feel about it, you know. So yeah. All right, I think I am done with my makeup basically. So I'll see you guys later. Thank you.